This line goes on and on.
Get your bag, let's go.
Forever. Goes around the block. People lined up because they hope to help their kids escape bad government-run schools by getting them into a charter school. But even after waiting in line, their kids may not get in because the line just got them in the building where they had to enter a lottery. Thousands of parents entered the lottery hoping for one of only a few hundred spots.
Here are some of the winners.
Congratulations.
Why are you so happy?
I pray for this.
But there are many more losers than winners. This woman just realized her grandson won't be picked. She's upset, but she tries to comfort her grandson.
I know your heart is broke. Mine broke too.
This is why we need school choice. Their hearts shouldn't be broken, says Betsy DeVos of the American Federation for Children. I agree with her, but Brian Jones says we're both wrong about school choice. Jones, a former teacher who runs, who's running for office now, is a Green Party candidate. So choice makes things better.
Well, choice can make things better, but in education, choice means that we are setting up children in a situation where they're competing against each other and where schools are competing against each other. Often the problem is that it's not the parents who do the choosing, but as we saw in that clip, it's the schools that do the choosing. And so what do you mean?
Oh, if there's a lottery, but if you allowed more charters, then the parent could pick a charter.
Sure, except that we see a pattern in charter schools, and especially the most celebrated charter schools, of pushing out students who have special needs, students who are English language learners.
That's absolutely false to begin with. The reality is that most charter schools in this country take the kids that are doing poorly in the schools that they were assigned to. And all the parents want is greater choice for their children. The more choices we have, the more competition we have, but also the better product or the better learning opportunity for the kids.
Yeah, Brian, I would think so. Why not just let them go to either one of your government schools or one of her charters? Just let the parent pick.
Right, except we're not letting the parent make all choices. There are certain choices that are not on the table. It's not a choice between stay and improve your school or go to this charter school. There's no choice to reduce class sizes in your school. The only choice that's being created for parents is the choice to pull your child out and try one of these other schools.
That's what makes schools better.
But it hasn't made the schools better.
Because there hasn't been competition.
It has. The reality is, in Florida, where there's probably the greatest array of choice, the schools, the districts in which there are a lot of choices for parents, the traditional public schools have actually gotten better. But the reality is that when you give parents choices, they make good choices on behalf of their kids, and they're happy with how their kids are doing. If they're not happy, they change to another school. And that's in every other area of our society, choices work.
We need parents to have the power and the opportunity to transform their schools. You showed a line of parents waiting to get into a charter school. I could show you a line of parents waiting to testify to save their public school from being closed down.
So why don't they save it? We were going to save these schools for the last 50 years.
Because there has been a push by people like yourselves to promote choice and to push parents out of the public system and into a more free market model.
The reality is we've been stuck in a factory model of education for 150 years. We're not in a factory model of society anymore.
But a lot of the choices that are proliferating have nothing to do with really innovating and teaching and learning. They're a different model of organizing schools, but they're not teaching technique. In fact, some of the most celebrated charter schools are even more emphasize testing and test preparation than do their public school counterparts.
But there are others that are innovating.
The parents can choose.
The problem is the more that we emphasize the proliferation of numerical options, the more we drain resources away from the public system. The public system needs to be robust and well-funded so that it can take anybody who walks through the door and serve them.
What would be well-funded? What is enough for you?
Well, let's look at what's happening right now in the charter schools who claim, like Eva Moskowitz's success academies, who claim, you know, the resources don't matter, it's not about money, and yet they spend more money per pupil than the average public school. They're raising money on Wall Street. What for?
The reality is that most schools that parents choose don't have as much as the traditional public schools, and yet they're doing better with what they have.
People in government love central planning. Why don't they learn that central planning usually fails? It failed drastically in the Soviet Union, though it took 70 years before people had the will and courage to make a change. Central planning also failed in Cuba, North Korea, at America's post offices, and in our government schools. Government monopolies just don't serve customers well. They don't have the incentive to serve them well. But somehow, politicians and others who love government control don't get that. But I guess that's not fair. I didn't get it until I'd done 15 years of consumer reporting. Now it's obvious to me that the only thing that does serve consumers well is competition. If you must please your customers or go out of business, you get better, you try harder, you innovate constantly.
So you guys look forward to going to school in the morning?
Yes!
But learning is work.
It don't matter.
Those kids enjoy school, and they outperform their peers by a lot. It's wonderful. But that also means it's a crime that only 4% of America's kids have that opportunity. Most don't have it because politicians and self-interest groups won't let them have a choice. Even as desperate parents in my city lined up hoping to win a charter school lottery that would let their kids escape horrible government-controlled schools, union protesters stood outside chanting, "Don't be fooled, abort charter schools."
Don't be fooled, abort charter schools.
They don't want competition. They told me things like, "Competition is not for education." But the opposite is true. Competition gives us better cars, computers, movies, music. It would work for education, too, if they just let it. The union teachers don't realize that if there were competition, they'd have more freedom, and most would make more money. Good teachers would make much more. Think about it. Americans don't realize how much government spends on education now. What do you think it is per student per year? $5,000? $8,000 per student? $8,000 per student would mean the government spends about $200,000 per classroom. That would be a lot. And yet the correct answer is government spends more than $12,000 per student. That's more than $300,000 per class. If there were market competition, good teachers could make $200,000 and have money left over to hire an assistant. So let's take that $12,000 and attach it to the student. Let his parents have a choice. Free them to send him and his $12,000 to any school. Let the schools compete for the money that's attached to his back. Then more kids will have an experience like these kids have.
School is fun?
Yes.
How is it fun to learn?
They just teach us in a fun way.
Well, all kids deserve that. We know what works. Competition. Let America's children enjoy its benefits.